भगवते वासु देवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीर्यये नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवतीरुत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी।
Today, Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 11, text number 46 to 49, we are going to discuss. 46 to 48, there is no purport, so I will read the sloka and translation. And 49, we will all read together. Text number 46.
Swam swam vatsakulam sarve payayishyanta ekada gatva jalashaya bhyasham payayitva vapurjalam.
One day, all the boys, including Krishna and Balram, each boy taking his own group of calves, brought the calves to a reservoir of water, desiring to allow them to drink. After drinking the animals, after the animals drank water, the boys drank water there also. 47.
ते तत्र ददृशूर्बाला महासत्त्वमवस्थितं तत्र सर्वज्ञ निर्भन्नं गिरेशृङ्गमिवच्युतम्।
Right by the reservoir, the boys saw a gigantic body resembling a mountain peak broken and struck down by a thunderbolt. They were afraid even to see such a huge living being.
48. Savai bako nama mahanasuro bakarupadru agatya sahasa krishnam tikshanatunchno grasid bali.
The great bodied demon was named Bakasura. He had assumed the body of a duck with a very sharp beak. Having come there, he immediately swallowed Krishna.
10:49, that is today's sloka, which is there on the board. Krishnam महाबकग्रस्तं दृष्ट्वा रामादयोर्बका। बभूवुरिन्द्रियाणि वा विना प्राणम् विचेतसः कृष्णं महाबकग्रस्तं दृष्ट्वा रामादयोर्भका। बभूवुरिन्द्रियाणि वा विना प्राणं विचेतसः
कृष्णं महाबकग्रस्तं दृष्ट्वा रामादयोर्भका बभूरिन्द्रियाणि वा विना प्राणं विचेतसः कृष्णं महाबकग्रस्तं दृष्ट्वा रामादयोर्भका बभूरिन्द्रियाणि वा विना प्राणं विचेतसः कृष्णं महाबकग्रस्तं कृष्णं महाबकग्रस्तं बभूरिन्द्रियाणि वा विना प्राणं विचेतसः
माताजी
word to word meaning translation and purport by Jagadguru Srila Prabhupada. Jagadguru Srila Prabhupada ki Krishnam, on to Krishna. Mahabhakagrastam, swallowed by the great duck. Drishtva, seeing this incident. Rama Adaya Arbakaha. All the other boys headed by Balarama. Babu Vu became overwhelmed. Indriyani, senses. Eva, like. Vina, without. Pranam, life. Vichetasaha, very much bewildered, almost unconscious. Translation. When Balarama and other boys saw that Krishna had been devoured by the gigantic duck, they became almost unconscious, like senses without life. You all can repeat after me. When Balarama and other boys saw that Krishna had been devoured by the gigantic duck, they became almost unconscious, like senses without life. Om Agnana Timirandhasya Gnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Sri Chaitanya Manobhistam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Svapadantikam. Vandeham Sri Gurun Sri Yutapada Kamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnavanscha Sri Rupam Shagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakhanvitanscha He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dinavandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tata Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanusute Devi Pranamami Hare Priye Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Krupa Sindhubhyayevacha Patitanam Pavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Mukam karoti vachalam pangum langaite giram yat krupatam aham vande Sri Gurun Dinatarinam Sri Chaitanya Ishwara. I offer my respectful obeisances at the lotus feet of all the Vaishnavas who are present here, who are quite senior and who are quite knowledgeable than me. I pray at the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada to give me the strength to speak as he has instructed. Today we have the most beautiful, bewildering incident that Krishna has been swallowed by the big duck, Bakasura. I'm extremely sorry. I pray at the lotus feet of all Vaishnavas to kindly excuse me. The purport, although Balaram can do everything because of intense affection for his brother, he was momentarily bewildered. A similar thing is stated to have happened in connection with Rukmini Harana, the kidnapping of Rukmini. When Krishna, after kidnapping Rukmini, was attacked by all the kings, Rukmini was momentarily bewildered until the Lord took the proper steps. Om Agnana Timiranda Sagnananjana Shalakya Chakshurun Militamena Tasmai Sri Guruve. Thank you very much. Otherwise, I would have committed offense. I'm very sorry. So we have the greatest episode where Krishna has been swollen. A great duck, Bakasura, swallows Krishna. And all the cowherd boys were looking and seeing, oh, our master, our dear friend, our protector, he has been swallowed. Then they became almost unconscious. Oh my God, they have fallen. Now what happens? Tomorrow we can see. Krishna shows his power. He had gone inside the neck of the duck, Bakasura, and then he becomes a very high temperature flame burning inside. When something is burning inside, naturally Bakasura opens his mouth big. Then Krishna comes down. When Krishna was seen unhurt, Bakasura tries to hurt him, kill him by his sharp beak. All these very beautiful slokas, very beautiful episode, we can see tomorrow, day after tomorrow, subsequent days. Here we see, Prabhupada has explained that a similar bewilderment also occurred when Rukmini has seen that Krishna has been attacked by so many kings in the Rukmini Harana, kidnapping of Rukmini. This is a very, very, very beautiful episode of Krishna kidnapping Rukmini, which we see from 10.52, 10.53 and 10.54. 10.52 onwards, the Leelas in Dwaraka start. Otherwise, all these are in Vrindavan. So, in 10.52, the complete description of Rukmini, how she invites Krishna to kidnap her. This is explained. I will just go through. Kundina is the capital of Vidarbha. Vidarbha king was Bhishmaka. Bhishmaka had four sons and one daughter. The eldest son is Rukmi. And the beautiful daughter she had was Rukmini. She is the direct expansion of Lakshmi Mata. Mother Lakshmi, who is the goddess of fortune. Rukmini hears the transcendental nature qualities of Krishna and fixes her mind on Krishna and chooses him as her husband. And on the other hand, Krishna also hears the transcendental qualities of Rukmini and he also fixes his mind on Rukmini. The father, Bhishmaka, actually understands the heart of Rukmini and he wants that Rukmini should be married to Krishna. But Rukmini, who has got the association of Jarasandha and all these wicked, cruel kings who are envious of Krishna, he opposes. And Rukmini, because the cruel people are always stronger, Bhishmaka, the father of Rukmini, understands that his word of marrying his daughter to Krishna may not work. He yields to the pressure applied by Rukmini and he arranges the marriage with Shishupal. Shishupal, Jarasandha, all these people are always envious of Krishna and always they are cruel in their behavior. Sri Sri Krishna Balaram, Sri Sri Radha Shyam Sundar, Sri Sri Gaur Nitai Ki Jai. So, now the problem is Rukmini wanted to marry, but by force she is being married to Shishupal. The marriage day, everything is arranged, and Rukmini was wondering what to do. She calls her confident Brahmana, old Brahmana, and gives him a letter, message. Actually, we can call it, it's a It's her love letter to Krishna. Rukmini's love letter to Krishna. We can see the beautiful text in 10:52-37-43. The way Rukmini has described her mind. Rukmini says in 37, the beginning of the letter, Krishna, I have learnt the transcendental qualities of yours, and having learnt your so many qualities, I lost my heart to you. O Krishna, kindly accept me as your wife. And I am expressing this without any shame. Shamelessly, I accepted you as my husband. And she tells, you see, tomorrow is going to be the beginning of the process of the marriage. So, I have a plan. If you kindly accept, kindly execute as per the plan. She tells in the message which the Brahmana reads to Krishna after reaching Dwaraka. Vidarbha to Dwaraka is quite a long distance, but with all great difficulties, this Brahmana reaches Krishna. And Krishna, after respecting the Brahmana, inquires, and the Brahmana is reading the letter given by Rukmini. So, Rukmini says, O Krishna, if you kindly accept, kindly, I have a plan for you. Tomorrow is the day when the process of marriage will take place and the bride will have to go out of the palace and go and pray at the lotus feet of Bhavani. And after praying to Bhavani, then I will be walking. I will be walking. And you kindly kidnap me when I will be walking, and the moment I see you, I will stop you, I will stop near you, and you kidnap me and take me. And you get me married in the Rakshasa Vivaha, that is by demonic marriage. At the end she says, by any chance, if you don't want to accept me, okay, I will wait for you. Life after the life, after hundreds of life, I will pray. And if you are merciful, then you accept me as my wife. So this way, when the Brahmana read the whole message, the letter of Rukmini, Krishna feels extremely happy. I was also feeling that I should go. So Krishna reaches along with the Brahmana. And Rukmini was waiting for the Brahmana to arrive. Brahmana comes and indicates that, I have come along with Krishna, don't worry, things are as per your plan. So, as per the plan, Rukmini moves out of the palace. And now she enters the Bhavani temple and prays to Bhavani as per the rituals. She decorates with so many ornaments and she comes out. Repeatedly, Rukmini was praying to Bhavani that Krishna only should be her husband. So now she started walking. All the kings, they were looking at Rukmini, so beautiful. And Rukmini was smiling because she was able to find Krishna. The moment she found Krishna, she started walking towards him, changing her style, changing her path. Krishna immediately catches her and lifts her and puts her in her chariot. And Krishna starts driving, and all the kings start throwing arrows at Krishna and Krishna's army. Here, Rukmini gets so much bewildered. Oh my God, so many kings are there, and with their so much of great army. Oh Krishna, you have such small army and you are alone. And so many arrows are falling. She gets bewildered. Just like the Gopa Balakas here, they got bewildered and they were almost unconscious. This is the one which has been referred here by Srila Prabhupada, that in the Rukmini Apaharana, in the kidnapping of Rukmini, Rukmini gets bewildered. So when Rukmini got bewildered, Krishna smiles at Rukmini and says, you see, Rukmini, don't worry. your soldiers, he uses the word, your soldiers will smash, kill, destroy all these enemies. Don't worry. Then, they destroy and Krishna moves on. Then her brother, Rukmi comes and tries to attack Krishna. This, we see the beautiful Krishna's pastime in 1053, 1054, 10th canto, chapter 53 and chapter 54 onwards. So here, actually, Krishna's pastime, each pastime, whatever we see, are suspense-filled super thrillers. It is just like all the movies, whatever these people they make, they take the actual guidance from here and they modify it so much for the material sense gratification of the people who are viewing it. But otherwise, each episode, each pastime of Krishna, which is described in Srimad Bhagavatam, is full of thrill and it gives so much pleasure for the listeners, and it actually does lot of good thing by removing our material attachment. Similarly, when we take the Kaliya incident, 10:16, canto 10, chapter 16, Kaliya being chastised by Krishna is described in detail. Here, Kaliya entered river Yamuna and he is playing in the river. Krishna is playing in Yamuna and Kaliya gets disturbed. Acharyas explained that the playing of Krishna in the river Yamuna is so melodious with the noise it generated is so melodious and so beautiful to watch Krishna. But this fellow, Kaliya, he becomes very furious and he moves very fast to Krishna and beat him in the chest. Not only he had beaten, he entraps him, coils around Krishna, entraps him in the coil. 10:16:10, it is very nicely described how the reaction of the cowherd boys. Now cowherd boys are at the bank of the river and they are watching Krishna. Oh Krishna has been coiled by this serpent. And Krishna is motionless. Seeing this, the cowherd community, they were so much disturbed. At the sight of the Lord in the clutches of Kaliya's snake, their intelligence deranged by grief, lamentation, fear, they all fell onto the ground. Not only the Gopa Balakas and all the cows, the 10:16:11 explains, cows, bulls, calves called out piteously to Krishna. They all stood in still in fear of this big snake catching Krishna. And they were ready to cry, but they were too shocked that they were unable to shed tears. Now, Nanda Maharaj gets the information and also he sees so many inauspicious things and he feels there is a great danger to Krishna. He along with all the people of Vrindavan, they run to Yamuna river, and they see that Krishna is motionless and in the clutch, in the coil of the serpent. They all become so nervous and they all fall down to the ground. Balaram knows that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead and he tries to tell them that nothing will happen to Krishna. And later on, you see, Krishna for such a long period, right from the cowherd boys had fallen and Nanda Maharaj and all the people, Yashoda, everyone had come, Krishna is motionless. You see, it looks as if Krishna is so perfect in his action that everyone gets the actual feel as if Krishna is really bound by the serpent. So this sort of incidents actually make the devotees to get immersed in the whole incident, and they become part of the whole episode, whoever was present and whoever is hearing carefully. Similarly, in Srimad Mahabharata, in Mahabharata war, Ashwatthama released Narayanastra. Narayanastra is the one which anybody who tries to attack, it will give more intense fire, missiles. So all Duryodhana and all Kauravas feel very, very happy. Ashwatthama has released the Narayanastra and we are going to win. These fellows will try to attack and they will be smashed within no time. When Narayanastra was present, Krishna tells everybody, nobody can get rid of Narayanastra. Nobody should attack Narayanastra. Just surrender on to Narayanastra. Leave all your weapons. Lie on the ground. Some soldiers, they felt, if we lie on the ground, that fellow, immediately we will be killed. Krishna says, no. When you surrender, that's all. The Narayanastra becomes calm. Just follow my instructions. One or two fellows who didn't follow, they were killed. Immediately it became very intense. So, when we see this, actually, it looks as if the war is going to end because the Narayanastra is so powerful, it will kill anybody. And anybody who is attacking Narayanastra, Narayanastra becomes so intense and it shows much more power and everyone will be smashed. But Krishna, when he is present, nothing such thing would happen. So Krishna, when the instructions are followed by the people, they will be saved. Krishna gives the instruction, surrender on to this Narayanastra, you will be saved. All were saved. Krishna gives us the directions in Srimad Bhagavad Gita. So whatever Krishna's direction, instruction, if we follow, we will also be saved from these material miseries. Otherwise, just like Narayanastra becoming intense, if we are more inclined to enjoy the material pleasures will only bind us so much that we can never come out of the material world, that is this. The thing is, with all this, listening to such nice pastimes, actually what anybody is going to gain? If somebody asks, then the Shastras are there to give very nice explanation. Here in the 10th canto, 7th chapter, Parikshit Maharaj says, why is after listening to Krishna's pastime? So, 10.7.1, 10.7.2, Parikshit Maharaj explains the reason for him, why he is after hearing of the pastimes. What actually anybody gains by hearing the pastimes? Yena yena avatarena. This is being told by Rajovacha. Parikshit Maharaj is saying, yena yena avatarena bhagavan haririshwaraha Karoti Karnaramyani Manognani Chana Prabho Yashrunvatopaityaratirvaktrushna Satvancha Shudhyatya Chirena Pumsa Bhaktirvarau Tat Purushe Chasakhyam Tadevaharam Vadamanyasechet. Parikshit Maharaj says, why I am after all this, listening more and more to Krishna's pastime? Parikshit Maharaj says, in brief, seven reasons he is giving. Pastimes of Krishna are pleasing to ear and mind. The dirty things in one's mind immediately vanish. The third point, he says, the pastimes are so attractive, so pleasing to mind. Everyone wants pleasure, so by listening to this very attractive and pleasing, a person feels happy. Number four, attachment to hearing these beautiful pastimes, material things, material listening, material activities will vanish. Hearing material activities will go. The fifth one, it develops devotional service to Krishna. Six, develops attachment for Krishna. Not only that, he gives the reason, number seven, develops friendship among the devotees who give Krishna consciousness. Now, if we try to understand how actually by listening to Krishna's pastime, our material things will go. This is explained in 1.2.7. Vasudeve Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojitaha Janayatyashu Vairagyam Jnanancha Yadahaitukam. By rendering devotional service, hearing is one of the devotional service. So by rendering the devotional service, one acquires causeless knowledge. Without any reason, he will get the knowledge, causeless knowledge and detachment from the material world. Again, it appears not so clear how actually the causeless knowledge will come, how he develops the detachment. This is explained in 1.2.17. Srunvatam Swakada Krishna Punya Sravana Kirtanaha Hudayantasyokhe Abhadrani Vidunoti Suhurtsatam. Krishna is present in everyone as the Paramatma, the Supreme Lord. And when the devotee, when the person is very carefully listening to the pastimes of Krishna, then Krishna feels, oh, this man is very seriously, he is listening. So he takes the charge within the heart, because he is sitting in the heart. He notices tons and tons of rotten garbage is there in the heart. He takes the charge of cleaning it. And he cleans Abhadrani. Hudayantasyoha Abhadrani Vidunoti Sohutsatam. Those who are very carefully listening with faith, Krishna takes the charge and he clears and cleans the heart. When Krishna cleans the heart, the material attachments, material desires are the garbage, tons of garbage, rotten garbage. The more you clean, the more it stinks. As the cleaning process is on, the more mind wants to get attached to material things. Just like when we see the garbage is being cleared here on the road, the more he clears, the more bad smell will be coming. But the person who hears all the pastimes with faith and with seriousness, he will get rid of all the material desires and he will become a pure devotee. That's why all the pastimes of Krishna, we have to listen it with extreme care. And today we have seen that the Bakasura is swallowing Krishna and all the cowherd boys are almost unconscious. Now tomorrow onwards we will see how Krishna fights and kills this demon Bakasura. So each one of you kindly listen to each one text and with great seriousness and taking total faith in Krishna, when we listen, we will definitely come out of this material bondage and we go back to our home, back to Godhead. I stop here and I request for the questions. If you feel I can answer them, please.
So the Krishna book stories are meant to attract us back to the spiritual kingdom. When Krishna's killing demons 2-3 times a day, big monstrous demons, it seems kind of scary, you know, trying to figure out how do we digest that every day, like, you know, he takes breakfast, kills a few demons, eats some lunch, kills a few more demons, and, you know, it seems like a storybook.
Yeah. Thank you very much for your very valuable question. Actually, I know you know the answer. For the benefit of everyone, you are asking. Thank you very much. Actually, each pastime, Krishna wants all his associates to enjoy. Everyone has taken birth, Bakasura also took birth, to participate in the big drama which Krishna is actually playing. So everyone is anxious. I should go. Now Bakasura, after that this, after this Didyaman, everyone is ready. So Krishna wants to actually make them enjoy his association. Whether Bakasura or Aghasura, each one being killed by Krishna, they go back to Godhead. Actually, that is the reason Krishna wants to show. And the devotees who enjoy, they get so much pleasure by seeing Krishna's power. Though for a moment they get bewildered, oh my God, my Krishna, my master is swollen. What will happen now? My protector. All cowherd boys were so much worried. Krishna wants to see them. Are they really worrying or not? When they are worrying, okay, Krishna says, yes. Now I will remove your worry. I have come back, come out. Oh, when Krishna has come out, everyone is happy. Oh, our Krishna has come out. He was inside the mouth. He was inside the, literally in the throat of this demon. Now Krishna has come out. Okay. Then everyone feels so happy. So to give the pleasure to his devotees, Krishna does all these pastimes. He wants that all the people who are on this material world should get attracted and take the path of devotional service. Just by listening, Sunanvatam Swakada Krishna Punya Sravana Kirtanaha Hudayanta Stokhi Abhadrani. The Abhadrani, the material desires are our Abhadra, our obstacles in our day-to-day life. So these are cleared by just listening to the beautiful pastimes of Krishna.
So when Krishna kills the demons, they go back to Godhead. So why doesn't Krishna just kill all of us and we all go back to Godhead? Why, you know, it doesn't seem, you know, he sets a good example generally, but the biggest demon causing so much trouble, Krishna kills him, he goes back to Godhead and we all got to struggle. Why he doesn't just kill all of us?
Fantastic. Yeah, the idea is good, but we should also deserve, no? We should deserve to be killed by Krishna. If we see whether Ravanasura, Hiranyaksha, Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu was such a great demon, and he had become such a great demon because he was such a great devotee. So if we become great devotee, again we can participate in the Leela in the pastimes of Krishna. And because we have forgotten Krishna, because our mind is not fixed on Krishna, we are suffering. And we continue to forget Krishna, and we continue to suffer, and we are in this material world because we have forgotten Krishna. If we remember always Krishna, and if we always think about Krishna and do all activities for Krishna, definitely we come to that stage. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
If you are giving that Krishna entered the in the mouth of the bird, Bakasura, and he became very hot, and they opened the mouth and the Krishna came out. Okay. So when Krishna is killing the demons, so he is doing all those things just like he killed that horse also. He put his hand and the hand became hard. So how Krishna can do all these things?
Krishna can do because Krishna is Krishna, the Supreme Lord, all powerful. Any power you say, topmost power possessed by Krishna. So Krishna is Krishna. There is nobody who is equal to Krishna. There is nobody who is slightly above to Krishna. No. So Krishna is Krishna. Krishna kills the demons by his own technique. Sometimes he just tears off these two beaks of Bakasura, and sometimes he drinks the milk and takes out the whole life. And sometimes he puts his hand in the mouth of the horse and stops the prana, the lifeline. And sometimes he just smashes. Sometimes he rolls the demon and throws with great force on the tree, and the demon falls being killed, just like Vatsasa. So each technique, Krishna has unique technique. His power cannot be, imagined, but we can understand little bit about Krishna.
Ravan and Hiranyakashipu were killed by the Lord, but they are exceptions because they were gatekeepers of the Lord.
Correct.
But if a demon is killed by the Lord, he merges in the Brahma Jyoti. He does not go to Golok. And a devotee, we are sitting here, we will no need to kill, but natural death will come, we will go to Golok.
Now, comparing with the death of a demon being killed by Krishna and our death, it is incomparable, number one, because Krishna is directly present and Krishna is doing that. Here, it is true in the Kali Yuga, Harinama eva kevalam, kalo nasteva, nasteva, nasteva gatirinida, only by remembering Krishna we can go back. But the mind is not so easy to control, not so easy to always remember Krishna, do all activities for Krishna. That's why it becomes very, very difficult. Only with the association of the devotees and only by taking shelter of the Vaishnavas, Guru, and becoming totally surrendered onto Krishna, it is possible. But to come to that stage, it is very, very difficult. We have to undergo the process. Yes, Prabhu, what you said is okay. Any other questions? Mataji, question you have? Yeah. Well, Mataji can ask question if you have 2 minutes.
Thank you for everything. How do you explain the feelings of the friends of Krishna around the Vrajavasi? They feel enthusiastic, some fall on the floor unconscious.
Yeah.
How to describe them and why they have. Yes.
Yeah, yeah, I understand your question. So, what is the feeling of the Brajavasis? The Brajavasis, whatever they do is only for Krishna, only for Krishna's welfare, only for Krishna's pleasure. So, whatever they perform, whether they are after taking care of the cows or whether they are taking the butter from the milk or whether they are milking the cows, taking out the milk, anywhere, anytime, the Brajavasis always remembering Krishna. Whatever activities, it is meant only for the pleasure of Krishna. So here they sometimes become like ordinary human beings, my Krishna is being saved by Vishnu, saved by devatas. They also feel, but the thing is, spontaneously in their heart they are doing all the activities for Krishna. That's why they are very highly elevated devotees.